Alright, folks, today we're making Dutch oven spare ribs. So stay tuned. It's time to grill. This is the moment I'm usually showing you how to light up a starting chimney full of briquettes. But today you will only need half of the amount of briquettes than usual. Take some starters, place your chimney over the starters, and then this is the moment I like best. We can smell smoke, and this is exactly the time to start with the preparation of the ribs. Today we are using Duroc ribs, and they are brought by my favorite online butchery, gourmetfleisch.de, and they are very meaty, and all you have to do is take away the silver skin. Take a spoon, put the spoon underneath the silver skin in the middle between two bones. Get down with the finger in between, pull it up, and then you have removed the complete silver skin. There are some moments I am not into barbecue flavor, not into too many barbecue rub things. That's why sometimes I like to season stuff like that with salt and pepper. We have just sprinkled over some sunflower oil and now seasoning this puristic with salt and pepper. The most of the time the ribs will be cooked in a Dutch oven. We will have some smoke flavor in the first phase, and the total cooking time for these ribs is 3 hours. But first things first. Now the charcoal briquettes are ready. Put them in two baskets. Set one basket on the left side and one on the right side. Set on the grill grates. Let the grill grates heat up and clean them. The smoke flavor comes from elder wood chips. Just place the ribs in the middle on indirect heat and put one handful of elder wood chips on each charcoal basket. This is all you have to do, and this might take between 20 minutes and 30 minutes until your ribs should have a nice brown smoked color. I'm not a fan of too much information about time and temp, because you should have a look what you're doing. A lot of people are doing 3-to-1 ribs with ribs without any meat, and they complain later on because they start to get dry. If you want to cook your ribs right, just keep an eye on how they look like. This is our Dutch oven. We will put some onions in there for some better flavor later on for the sauces. And now look how cool the ribs look like, and this is only 20 to 30 minutes of smoking. Place them in the Dutch oven and add some liquids. We are using beer. Beer is always the answer, but sometimes I forgot the question. Okay, about half bottle of beer here. And the ribs should be steamed. That's why you need a lot of fluid inside the Dutch oven. Now take off the grill grates, and the first charcoal briquettes are going under your Dutch oven, and the briquettes inside the second basket go on top. Be careful if you have the right charcoal. The temperature is good. If it's too hot, just take some away, remove some on top from the bottom, whatever you like. Just keep an ear and an eye on your Dutch oven. After 1 hour, I checked and I realized we lost a lot of that beer. That's why we are adding more beer. Later on, we will have a sauce and we will do something with the sauce. That's why you just have to keep on putting beer inside the Dutch oven. This is the cooking time after 2 hours inside the Dutch oven, which means 2 hours and 30 minutes of total cooking time. Now take off the Dutch oven. In the meantime, I have prepared again half full of starting chimney with more charcoal briquettes, and get the charcoal briquettes to the same position than in the first phase. Put on the grill grates again and place the ribs in the middle. Exactly like the first phase again. And they are already a little bit soft. Now we take off the whole liquids inside the Dutch oven. What I haven't showed you is that I took away a little bit of the fat. So we have the drippings of the meat and the onions, and I just took away some of that fat and mix it with barbecue sauce. This makes a real rich and full of flavor sauce, which is the perfect glaze for today's ribs. Sprinkle over the glaze. And I really already like the color of the ribs. They're looking so good. After you are ready with the barbecue sauce on the ribs, the last phase is again a little bit less than 30 minutes. And as I mentioned in the beginning, keep an eye on the ribs. The sauce will now start to caramelize quickly, and you don't want to burn them. Here is how it looks like after 20 minutes, and for me it's just perfect. On the first in the front, you can see that it starts getting darker and darker, so the perfect timing, they should not be there longer. Now they are already very, very soft. A lot of people and a lot of my viewers like fallen off the bone ribs. I'm not a too big fan of that. For me, those ribs are a little bit overcooked. I like if they are soft, but sometimes it's good to know why you have teeth. Okay, maybe this is complaining on high level. They are really, really full of flavor, full of barbecue sauce, smoke flavor, and they only took 3 hours to be cooked. Anyway, tastes awesome. Please hit that like button and subscribe. We are seeing us again in the upcoming days. Thanks for watching. I'm out. See you.